Imtiyaz Qureshi is now joining us this afternoon. Imtiyaz, good afternoon. What do you make of 7600? Say if we close in and around this level, what signals are you getting?
Good afternoon, Pankaj. No doubt, as it is expecting that today the market would trade or maybe hover nearby 7600 and try to close above 7600. I suppose that from our last 4 days of downside journey, today we had taken some pause, and today being the fifth day, so also a Fibonacci number. So I think so this is going to extend little bit, maybe for another couple of days before any bounce back arrives. As of now, majorly I'm looking for 7500 put option, where highest open interest has been built up around 60 lakh open interest. So that range would not be breakable so easily, but Nifty can come once to nearby that level, and then we can see a sharp recovery. As of now, I would recommend that sell on rally rather than going on buying on decline.
Right. So, you know, if you want to sell on rally, what are the names that you would look at? Let's start with the large caps first.
Pankaj, already we have seen many damages in most of the frontline stocks, so it is not at the perfect time to go short. But maybe if the rally comes back to back to 7800 or maybe 7750, at that point of time, need to be understand which are the short candidate at that level. But as of now, most of the frontline stock, if we talk about high beta stocks, almost most of them has gone into the oversold zone. Even the Nifty is trading into oversold zone. So all this going to take a little bit of days, maybe 2 or 3 days would take. And thereafter, we can understand that maybe the trend would change, or maybe the sell-on rally would continue.
Right, but you know, but still, you know, next 2 days, how would you look at? What would you want to, you know, go short on? Which are the names that you're looking at? Say if they go higher, what are the names that you would look at?
Pankaj, I would be looking for some of pharmaceutical companies where I would be very much choosy and stock specific. Like Cipla is not showing good performance in last couple of days, and today and day before yesterday. And yesterday also we have seen some sort of a hammering. So Cipla would be the one candidate. If rally comes back, then I would definitely see for some shorting opportunity. And if I go for the IT sectors, then maybe Infosys would be the one, but I would definitely wait before making any initiate. And auto sectors are almost going on a decline. If you see Tata Motors, if you see Maruti Suzuki, which has been hammered for maybe around 4 to 5% just couple of days. So these are the candidates which are looking for the, you can say, shorter side. But immediately, as I said, I would not make any trade as of now until unless the Nifty is sustaining above 4,500. And maybe few choosy...
Above 4,500?
7,500, sorry. 7,500, and would be very much choosy on the buy side.
Right. So what would you do now? You would wait for Monday. Say if we open flat at these levels and global markets are fine, what would you do on Monday morning?
Pankaj, I would like to give small chart structure where I'm expecting the market is on the last leg of downside. And if it is, as we say that this is a diamatic formations and this is a G leg, it is opened 4 days back itself. And if this is the scenario where the A leg is equal to G leg, so that would Nifty going back to below 7,500. So as I said...
And once we go below 7,500, what are the levels next to look at?
Max to max 7,400, not below... not major below to that 7,400. And the first A leg has taken almost 13 days of time frame. So this will also going to take at least minimum 8 to 13 days. Today has been fifth day. So another 3 days would be the probability the market would consolidate or either show some sort of a weakness. So in 3 days, we can expect the market going back to 7,400, and then we can see a bounce back. So as I said, I would not like to judgment anything because almost the damages has been occurred. 7,500 trying to prove and himself as a very strong support. So if all this get happened, then GLA could get over in next 1 to 2 days of time frame where the consolidation happened, and then we can see the fresh rally going higher side.
Right, Imtiyaz. Just stay with us, Imtiyaz. Markets are about to close. No major changes today. In fact, a very, very calm day today compared to the panic that we had seen yesterday. Vedanta up 0.06%, SBI flat about 1 rupee on the lower side, Axis Bank up 1.5%, Tata Motors up 2.8%. It was down 6% yesterday. For the week, it's down, I think, almost about 10 to 12 percent. Hindalco up 0.39%, ITC up 0.8%, Power Grid up 2.5%, Zee Entertainment down about 1%. ONGC up close to about 2%, Reliance up 1.5%, Adani Ports down 1.6%, almost closing in towards the day's low. NTPC 1.45% higher. Bank of Baroda up about 0.79%. PNB are flat, absolutely flat. L&T again hitting a 52-week low, 2.5% decline. BHEL flat with a negative bias. Cain India 1% higher. I think it's because of the crude bounce back that we are seeing. Yes Bank is up 2.3%. Sun Pharma is up 1.5%, close to 1.25%. Ambuja Cement is absolutely flat. Idea, no change. Bharti up 2 rupees. HCL Tech up 0.75%. Infosys was up 1.3%. M&M a quarter of a percent higher. Tech Mahindra did very well. 2.3% higher today. HUL down about 1%. Maruti down 1%. TCS up about 1.2%. Asian Paints up absolutely flat. Up about 1 rupee or so. GAIL up 3 to 4 rupees this afternoon. Wipro up 1%, HDFC Bank, no change. It actually never fell as well. Lupin off the day's high, but still down about a quarter of a percent. That's the closing bell that has rung. Markets have shut for the day, markets have shut for the week. Definitely a week that you would want to forget. Chinese markets, I was looking, were down almost 10% this week. Indian markets are also down about 3% or so. Grasim up about 0.36%. Bosch up about 0.5%. Vedanta up about a quarter of a percent. ICICI Bank down 0.5% SBI down about a quarter of a percent. Axis Bank up 1.6. Tata Motors up 3%, 354 for Tata Motors. ITC up 1%, Tata Steel up about 1%. Tata Power was the top gainer. There has been an initiation which has come in from Nomura, and probably that has sparked a rally into this name. Tata Motors, the next top gainer. Tech Mahindra, the third gainer. Power Grid was up 2.5. BPCL back to yesterday's highs, 905 rupees for BPCL. Yes Bank up 2.3%, closer to the 700 rupee mark. IndusInd Bank 292, just about 50 rupee away from an all-time high. IndusInd Bank, we can just pull up that name. It's really a name which has not fallen, that and HDFC Bank. IndusInd Bank 2.5% higher. ONGC was up 2%. Again, that's because I think because of the crude bounce back, because these names yesterday were pricing in as if crude is never going to recover. Tata Steel 2% higher, 255 rupees for Tata Steel. Axis Bank 1.6% higher. Reliance Industries again supporting the market, 1.5% higher, 1027. Ultratech, Infosys, TCS. Infosys and TCS both declare numbers next week. So we'll wait and watch for those two names. Two, three losers also. So L&T was down 2.5% at a new 52-week low. Cipla was down close to 2%. Bajaj Auto, 2% decline, 2,371. We spoke to the management this afternoon. Adani Ports down 1.5%. Coal India down 1.3%, 322. Hero Motor Corp down 1.2%. HUL was also down about 1%. And Maruti, after a 4% cut yesterday, was down another 1% or so. Some of the names in the broader market space. So all the sugar pack did well. The full sugar pack was doing quite well. Balrampur Chini was up 10%. Bajaj Hindustan was up close to about 10-odd%. And some of the other sugar names did very, very well. Sri Renuka on your screen, up 8% or so. Let's look at the content providers. So Shimaru was up 14%. Saregama, Tips Industry, Eros Now, everything that has got to do with content also did very, very well. Shimaru Entertainment was up 14-odd%. Saregama, Tips, Saregama was up 6. Let's look at Tips and Balaji Telefilms. These are other names that have done very, very well. Genus Power was up 11%. It's a name which has been doing well. Numbers were very, very strong, and it's up close to about 11%, 1.3 million shares for that name. Kalyani Steel was up 10%. Throughout the day, actually, Kalyani Steel was strong. Not sure if there is any news flow, but that was particularly quite strong. Hotel stocks bounced back again. So you look at a Royal Orchid Hotel, it's up 10% today. And the list of hotel names just goes on. Royal Orchid, Indian Hotel was Indian Hotel has been flat off late, but Royal Orchid did very, very well. Tata Coffee went up during the day. It was up 12% towards close, 109, 110. For Tata Coffee towards the close. Some of the other losers, Lycos Internet was down 2.5%. Apart from that, not any major losers actually that I can find. Okay, ST Aluminium was down a full 20. CARE has gone down and derated or made a default rating of their company's loan. So it's down 20. It was down 20 yesterday. So 2 days It's now down about 40-odd percent. Let's look at Jubilant Foodworks, 2.5% decline. Treehouse Education was down about 3-odd percent. These are some of the other losers in the market. We were talking to Imtiyaz. He's still with us. Imtiyaz, what do you do of Infosys, TCS results next week? How should you look at them?
Pankaj, as of now, both the stocks look a little bit on a consolidation with the negative zone. So maybe the next couple of days would be very much careful for this both the stocks. And as of now, I'm expecting that maybe the TCS can go back to somewhere near the support around 2340 or maybe 2300. And from there, we can see a bounce back. And simultaneously, we are expecting that maybe Infosys shows some sort of a weakness again. Because as of now, we had seen the way the market has been corrected. Infosys has given the same contribution to the market. So I believe that 1020 is a very crucial support for Infosys. If that breaks, then I think so the Infosys can go in the triple digit, maybe below 1000.
Right. If we look at Infosys or we look at TCS, TCS would be declaring numbers first. So can you just give your outlook on TCS as well? Because I think that will be the trendsetter this time versus Infosys. Infosis declares on Thursday.
Yes, Pankaj, as I said that there is a very strong level for the TCS 2340. Till the result comes out and the TCS doesn't break 2340, then definitely we're going to see on a higher side. But today was the first day where we had seen the higher top, higher bottom formation, plus the closing nearby the day high. So this is a little bit of indication that maybe the stocks can show some sort of a potential moment before the result comes out. An actual moment would definitely see at the time of result. So as of now, I can say only the market, the stocks is on a, you can say, consolidation with a negative zone. Higher side, maybe you can see in a couple of days, somewhere around 2430 to around 2440. And from there, we can see against the seller coming in.
Right. How would you look at some of these housing finance company? LIC Housing today was also up 4%. It's really never gone off the days. It's really never fallen from the all time high.
Absolutely right, Pankaj. But as I said, I'm being very much choosy since the market is totally showing in a negative zone. If somebody is looking for the investment in housing finance, then I think so. Indiabulls Housing Finance look very much promising at this level. A couple of days back, we had seen some sort of a breakout getting emerge. So one can expect that a very good return coming in Indiabulls Housing Finance. Maybe around 8-9% of rally on a higher side we can see. Today was the first day where we had seen the stocks showing a higher top, higher bottom formation on a closing basis. So around 706 would be the stop loss for the Indiabulls Housing Finance. On the higher side, one can expect at least 770, 780 or maybe till 800 in couple of trading session.
Right, but overall housing finance companies, the charts over there are looking good. The long-term run that they have been given with, or the way they have been moving, they'll continue to give returns in that manner.
Yes, Pankaj, the performance of the company would continue to grow as what we had seen a few months back itself, where LIC was showing very good performance, DHFL and Indiabulls Housing Finance. But since when we had gone into this consolidation zone on the negative side, the stock-specific activity will be very much higher. Rather than going for the LIC or maybe Indiabulls Housing, DHFL, I definitely prefer Indiabulls Housing Finance on the technical front.
Right. Let's talk about PNB. It's at 105 rupees. Any sort of chance of it bouncing back from there?
Pankaj, this is a perfect example of one side going down for the stocks. From the level of 146, stock has almost gone to 105. What we can hope is that the stock has gone into the deep oversold zone. So bounce back would likely to see, but until unless we don't get a convictions on the higher top, higher bottom formation on a closing basis, there would be very much less probability of the stocks going higher. But since we are the stock is trading at an oversold zone, maybe a day can be given to the stocks where we can see a positive close or maybe a couple of positive close. Then only we can expect the retracement can happen from the level of 146 to 104.
Right, but what is the sort of levels that you're looking on the downside?
Pankaj, in 2000, I suppose in 2014, there was a bottom at 99 rupees. That would be the level to be watch out, because I don't think so that level should be getting broke. Anyhow, if that broke, then there could be a multiple sell-off coming in for the PNB. But that level would be very much crucial, because that would be 2014 year's bottom. So that will be a very strong level, 99 rupees.
Right. Jubilant Foodworks, after the results, very volatile, but now significantly on the lower side. 1360 is where Jubilant Foodworks is. How would you look at that name? Continuously looking weak?
Pankaj, today the stock has given a negative divergence below 1395. So more the time the stock sustained below 1395, there would be a probability the stocks can go back to around the recent rally from where the stock has come up, that is 1323. That level can be retest again. Trend looks negative, so I think so the downside can be open till 1323.
Right. Reliance Infra, Reliance Capital, last week stars, this week absolutely flat. How would you look at these names?
I think so. There is a small pause in the journey. Journey has not yet over for all these stocks. I suppose that the journey will continue as per the market conditions. We have seen a very good rally in Reliance Infra, Reliance Capital, even R Power, Reliance Communications, Reliance Industry, still outperformer these days. Today also being outperformer Reliance Industry. So there is a pause in the journey, but not yet the negative journey has started. I think so. This is a consolidation zone, and I would recommend buy on decline strategy for entire ADHG Group and Reliance Industry.
Right, but ADAG Group, you're convinced that it will continue to go up, because we've seen such rallies earlier, but most of the rallies seem to be sold into.
Yes, Pankaj, this is a very much, you can say, a phenomenon for the market. When ADAG perform, the market tend to show a negative trend. So, but I suppose if I look after the technical front, so I don't think so this could going to happen. It's just a normal phenomenon where we are seeing that the market is journey going down. But I think so that there has been a pause and the retracement has started. Any decline comes, I think so third leg which is going to go up higher. Very much positive for the ADAG Group.
Right. What do you make of SKS Microfinance? Clearly a anti-banking move that this name is having.
Yes, Pankaj, from last around 8 to 10 trading session, we have seen a very good performance in the stocks with the higher top, higher bottom formation. And this rally is going to continue. More or less, today the candle formation showing that there is an upper shadow on the higher side. So I think so some profit booking would arise. If at all the stocks go below 520 level, then I think so the rally could get paused at that level, and downside journey can see around below 500 level. So little bit cautious on the higher side.
Right. Imtiaz, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Always a pleasure talking to you.